Voltage divider bias is a way of biasing a transistor. And here, when you bias a transistor, the value of Q point will be set. Now, we'll analyze the voltage divider bias. First of all, we discuss about the reason why the biasing is called as voltage divider bias. Because see, R1, R2 along with VCC form a voltage divider. So that is why this biasing is called a voltage divider bias. Now to understand the expression for the Q point. So first we get the expression for the DC load line. Now how to get the DC load line? To draw the DC load line, what we do is we'll apply KVL to the output loop. Which is the output loop? Output loop is this. This is VCC. This is another way of writing. This is VCC. So you apply KVL to this loop. So this is therefore is VCC that is equal to voltage across RC, that is IC into RC plus voltage across the collector emitter. This is VCE plus VCE plus voltage across this resistor, that is IE into RE, Ohm's law. So this is IC and this is IE. Now IC and IE are almost the same. So IE is almost equal to IC. So we will approximate here. Therefore, the above expression becomes VCC is equal to IC into RC plus RE plus VCE. Now this is the equation. Now how to draw the DC load line? DC load line is the line drawn on the output characteristics of a transistor. So this is IC, this is VCE. Now this will be the DC load line. So here this is the output characteristics. It goes like this, etc. Now how to get the expression for these two points? So here IC equal to 0. So you substitute IC equal to 0 in this equation. So when IC equal to 0, what do you get? VCE is equal to VCC. So VCE, we call it as VCE cutoff, that is equal to VCC. So this expression, this term becomes 0. Now next, to get this point, here VCE is equal to 0. So when VCE equal to 0, what do you get? In the same expression, IC equal to, we'll write IC saturation, because this is the saturation point, which is equal to IC equal to how much? VCC by RC plus RE. VCC divided by RC plus RE. So this is the expression for the IC. So this is one end point that is equal to VCC cutoff or VCC. This is VCC divided by RC plus RE. Now, what is the slope of this curve or a straight line? So to have a slope of a straight line, so this is a straight line, so we can get or arrive at the equation in the form y is equal to mx plus c. What is y here? IC. So from this equation, I will write IC that is equal to VCC minus VCE divided by RC plus RE. So I will rewrite this as, which is equal to, I'll bring this in the form of Y is equal to MX plus C. What is Y? Y axis is IC. Y is equal to, that is IC equal to MX plus C. So this is minus 1 by RC plus RE into Y is equal to M into X. X is VCE, no? So therefore this is VCE plus C, that is constant, that is VCC divided by RC plus RE. So what is the slope? Slope is minus 1 by Re plus Rc. So this is having a negative slope. The slope is minus 1 by Rc plus Re. So this is the slope of this. Okay. Now this is the DC load line. Now what is the expression for the Q point? Q point. So how to calculate the Q point? First you calculate IC. Then you calculate VC. Now how to calculate IC? You from the input side you calculate IC. So how you calculate IC using the input side? See, I will take the voltage across R2 as V2. Now this is a voltage divider. So what is the voltage across R2? That is V2. V2 is equal to VCC into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. This is a voltage divider. So the voltage across any resistor, that is equal to total voltage into that particular resistor divided by sum of the resistors in series. Now this is V2. What is VE from this? VE is the voltage across RE. This is VE. What is VE? VE is equal to V2 minus VB. VE is this voltage. This voltage is equal to this voltage minus this voltage. This is VB. This voltage is equal to this voltage plus this voltage. KVL. Okay. So from this you can calculate IE. IE will be equal to V by RE. Because you know the value of V, therefore I is equal to Ohm's law. You apply Ohm's law, so V divided by Re. Now you know that I E is approximately equal to IC. So I E is approximately equal to IC. Therefore, this is equal to V E divided by Re. So we got I C. Next, we need to calculate the value or get the expression for V C. To get the expression for VC, apply Ohm's KVL to the output. What do you get? We already seen in the expression for the DC load line. So that is VCC, that is equal to ICRC plus VCE plus IERE. IC and IE are almost the same. Therefore, VCC, that is equal to IC into RC plus RE plus VCE. So from this, what is VCE? VCE, that is equal to VCC minus IC into RC plus RE. So this is the expression for the value of collector to emitter voltage. So this is the value of VCE and this is the value of IC. For a given circuit, all these values are constant. R1 is constant, R2 is constant, VCC is constant, RC. All these values are constant. Therefore, there will be a value of for VCE and its corresponding IC. So that will be on the DC load line itself. So this is the operating point or Q point. Now, this voltage divider bias is widely used in amplifier circuits. That is why this is called universal bias. Why this is used in most of the amplifier circuits? Because it is a stable biasing arrangement. It is a stable bias. What do you mean by stable bias? So here, Q point will be stable. That means there is no variation of IC and VCE whatsoever may be the reason. So what are the ways or reasons when IC and VCE or Q point changes? See, let us say, as the temperature increases, the surrounding temperature, or when the transistor is operating for a long time, the temperature of the transistor increases. When the temperature increases, that will increase the collector current. Because you know, when the temperature increases, the current due to the minority charge here is also increased. Therefore, the collector current, which is nothing but the sum of majority and minority charge carriers, that also will increase. When IC increases, See, if this is IC, when IC increases, this was IC, due to temperature, VCE will decrease. When VCE decreases, the Q point will change. But here, what happens is, as IC increases, the voltage across RE, that also will increase. VE. Why VE increases? Because what is VE? VE is nothing but IE into RE. What is IE? IE is approximately equal to IC. VE increases, that is, this voltage increases. But you know, this voltage is constant, that is V2. So you apply KVL here, what you get? V2, that is equal to this voltage, that is VBE plus VE. Okay, so since VE increases, V2 is constant, VBE has to decrease. So that is VBE has to decrease. Now, when VBE decreases, you know that this is a diode. The forward bias on the diode decreases because this is the characteristics of a diode. Okay, now let us say initially this is the value of VBE. And its corresponding IB is this. So let us say if IB is this one, VBE is this. Okay. Now when VBE decreases, IB will decrease. When IB decreases, you know IC also will decrease. IB decreases. IC decreases therefore. Why? Because IC equal to beta times IB. See here. IC here was increased, which is compensated by decrease in IC. So the even if IC increases, that will be compensated by decrease in IC. Therefore, the Q point in this case is maintained constant. So this circuit gives a stable Q point, which is the requirement for any device or a transistor circuit.